Hello, today I am going to describe how to solve programmatically a problem of skyscrapers. So let's imagine that we have a number of block buildings which are in line, and each building might have, they might vary by height, right? So let's index them from 0 for the moment, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah? And let's add some, assign them some height. For example, this will be height of, let's say, 4, this will be 3, this will be also 3, this will be 4, this will be, for example, 7, this will be 4, 4, and 4, yeah. And the problem is as follows. Let's imagine a guy on the roof on the very first building. He has a special unit that he can travel with this unit only horizontal, like a broom. So, for example, he can go from this skyscrapers, from this, because they the skyscrapers on index 0 and 3, they are of the same height. So he can also travel from 1 to 2, because those adjacent skyscrapers are also of the same height. But he cannot travel from 3 to 5, because between those buildings is another one which is much higher, and it blocks him to continue his journey. Alright, so the task is how to calculate the total number of possible routes between skyscrapers of equal height in a given collection. First of all, let's try to think a bit about how to calculate the number of possible routes between a given small group of skyscrapers with equal height. For example, let's take into account those three skyscrapers. We have three of them. So they are at index 5, 6 and 7. So let's draw a very simple grid like this. 5, 6, 7, 5, 6, 7. So clearly we can see that we cannot travel from 5 to 5 because we are already on this on the roof of this building. From 6 to 6 also we can't, and from 7 also we can't travel. So we can travel from 5 to 6, from 5 to 7, from 6 to 5, from 6 to 7, from 7 to 5, and from 7 to 6, which means that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 possible routes for given 3 skyscrapers. So if we have n equals 3, which is the number of given skyscrapers, we, in this particular example, we have 6 possible routes between them. So let's draw those routes. So we can travel from this one to the very last one, from this one to the adjacent. From this we can travel here to the left and to the right, and from this we can travel to the very first and also to the adjacent, which give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 possible routes. Yeah? So this grid let us infer some equation that we can apply later when we will try to count all possible routes for the whole collection. So this equation is as follows: n, which is the number of skyscrapers, multiplied by n minus 1. So this equation led us to calculate the number of possible routes between given number of skyscrapers with the same height. Okay, this is very, very important equation, because we will use it later on when we will try to approach this this problem with main algorithm. Okay, let's erase it for the moment. and try to think how we can count all possible routes in this given collection. How we can solve it programmatically. So first and very obvious idea, I would say the brute force approach is to iterate over collection, and for each index try to find other skyscrappers with the same height till we come across another skyscrapers which is higher and block us to continue our journey. So this solution assumes one iteration and over whole collection, and possible n iterations like the size of the collections per each element, which lead us to the conclusion that this solution has not very satisfying complexity, which is in big O notation it is very close to O n square. What we would like to do, we would like to achieve efficiency which will be proportional to the number of elements of collection. So in big O notation we want to have linear complexity for that solution. Okay, having said that, what we can do? One of the possible solutions to calculate the total number of possible routes between equal skyscrapers in the given collection is to use stack structure. Stack structure is a LIFO structure, which means last input, first output. Yeah. Mm. So I will show you how to solve this this problem using a stack. But for now, let's try to again write our formula, which is independent from the algorithm we are using for calculating the number of routes between given number of skyscrapers. Okay. So let's start. We will try to iterate just one this collection. So at the very beginning we have empty stack. We are at index 0. So we put on the stack the skyscrapers of height 4. We continue. On the index 1 we have skyscrapers at with height 3. Which means it is less than our very last element on the stack. So if it is less, we put it on the stack. So our stack extends. So we have 4, 3 on the stack. The next element on index 2 is 3. We see that it is equals to our last element on the stack. If it is equals or less, we do as in previous one iteration. So we just add it to the stack. The next element, the link has height of 4. If it's higher than the last element in our collection, if it is higher, we have to take some calculations for this moment. So if it is higher than the last element on the stack, what we are trying to do is we will try to pop each element, every element from the stack till we find another which is the same height that we just came across or higher than the one that we came across. So we will be popping all the elements from the stack till we find another element which is at least 4 or higher. So when we pop those elements, we might find a groups of skyscrapers of the same height, and to each group we will apply this equation and increase the total amount of possible routes that we started to calculate. So in this particular case we have on the stack two elements with height of 3. So there are two of them. So if you apply this equation at this place, we will get 2 multiple 2 minus 1, which give us total 2 roots. remember those total roots and continue. As we calculated those total number of roots for those elements, we can pop them from the stack and add to the stack element of height 4 that we just came across. Another element on index 4 has height 7. It's also higher, so it blocked us to continue our journey. If it is higher, we also we do it exactly the same what we did in the previous step. So we are popping elements from the stack as long as we have elements lower than the one that just we came across, or we reach or the stack is empty. So we have two elements of height 4. If they are two, we also apply this equation for them, and we have two possible routes between them. If we have two possible routes between them, we are adding to the total, which gives us 4, and we remove them from the stack. After removal, we add 7 to the stack. Next element at 5 index is 4, which is lower than 7, so we put it to the stack. Next element is also 4, and next element is also 4. So this leads us to the final stack, 7, 4, 4, 4. So this is the stack that we obtained at the moment when we reached the end of collection of skyscrapers. So we have total, which is 4, but we see that we have still some elements on the stack, so we have to calculate for them also a number of for each group that we find on the stack. We will have to apply the same formula. So we are popping from the stack each element till we find the one which is different. And if we see that we have a group at least of two elements, we are applying this formula and increase the total. So for this, we are popping 4, 4, and 4. We have 7. So we have 3 elements of height 4, and we calculate this formula. 3 multiple 3 minus 1, which gives us 6. We add it to the total. So total is 10 possible roots. Last element is 7, but we cannot find another element with height 7 of the stack. So we don't apply any formula, and we just finished our algorithm. So total number is 10. So we have 6 possible routes between those skyscrapers, 2 possible routes here, 2 possible routes here, which gives us 10. So this approach has a linear complexity, so we can imagine a huge collection, for example, thousands of thousands elements, and this guarantees us that we will not the time consumption will be proportional to the number of elements in the stack. Okay, so if you have any questions regarding this problem, please put them in a comment, and I will put my solution in Java along with spoke tests. Actually, it will be a link to my GitHub repository. Thank you.